Thank you. You can have a seat. My name is Beverly Trotter. I'm the director of Savannah U City. Savannah U City is a nonprofit organization, and our mission is to build the best leaders through engagement, encouragement, accountability, and the removal of institutional and environment barriers. Today, I'm going to talk to you about what we're doing. We're doing zones of peace in Savannah. And in zones of peace, we're not trying to tackle a whole community at one time, because how many of y'all know that's impossible? That's impossible. So we're doing it block by block. Is that all right? And we need your help. So doing this block by block thing that's called zones of peace in West Savannah, we're going to do street by street by street. And we're going to stay there for 90 days. So we're going to give you an opportunity to bring your skills and what you have to offer, whatever that is, whether that's getting licenses, whether it's strengthening the family, whether it's offering them anything you think can strengthen that family. Because we do know you got to strengthen the whole family. Yeah. You can't just strengthen part of a family and expect change. We have to strengthen the whole body, the whole family. So whether it's just fixing a porch, whether it's just taking them to the bus stop, whether it's just teaching them how to get life insurance, we have to do that. And while we're doing that, we're giving them an opportunity to change their situations.
The next step of our solution is that we want to look towards being the citizens of Reedville. Because we need transparency. We need transparency that when things happen with our youth, with our families, with our kids, whoever it is, that we have some kind of recourse. And the community knows exactly what happened. These things come out and we're able to talk about it. So I want to get up. I want to talk about it. See, we have the mayor here. See, we have the sheriff here. So I want to let you guys know that's what we're looking for. That's what we're looking for you to support. So communities has more trust. There's more trust back with the police department, with law enforcement, and we move forward in a very transparent way. So those are two things that I want to talk about. That is what I'm wishing for through the NAACP Prison Committee. And I hope that if anybody else wants to get active and involved in the community and figure out how you can come out here and affect change, come on out to the NAACP, join, and see what you can get on here.
God's good.
Yes, sir.
All the time.
That's good.
I want to first tell you that I'm extremely happy to be before you today. I recognize Senator Diane Harvey Johnson is in the back also. Senator Harvey Johnson was a past chair of our Georgia Legislative Black Caucus. And if you talk to her or talk to me, she will tell you this is not new. Police brutality is not new. And some of you don't understand that, but when you were black male, you know that police brutality is not new. You know, and I had to have a talk. Well, I have a 17-year-old son. And everybody who has a son knows that you have to have a talk with your son.
Hey. Tell.
And it's not about sex. It's about what to do when the cops stop you.
Exactly.
Not if you're going to be stopped.
When.
But it's about what to do. Not to have to talk about something about where to put your hand. You know, what to say. All right. Don't reach down. Tell the person you're riding with or riding with you. All right. Don't say anything, but put your hand somewhere that everybody sees. Because if not, son, I'm worried you may not go home. But I don't know this from y'all, because my dad used to work in Long County, about 50 miles away from here. He traveled with a pistol to and from work. And I always asked him, Dad, when I'm thinking, why you got a car, a pistol, to get on? You think somebody made an offer? He says, no, it's for the police in Long County. So some of you don't understand, but this ain't good. The only thing new about today's world is this right here.
There you go.
This is the only thing.
Technology, beautiful thing. That's our weapon right there.
If you have one, keep one ready. Because this is the only thing news has happened. 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 50 years ago, we always complained of police brutality. As a member of the Black Caucus, number one issue, we've been treated differently when we're arrested. And now we're going to You know, my son wanna have braids in his hair. I'm afraid to.
Okay.
Because he might be
stereotype.
And I said, no, boy, you gotta cut your hair.
That's his hair.
Yeah, no, for my sake. All right, now when you get to be 25, do what you want to do. So this issue is real, not only in Savannah, not only in Georgia, but in America.
Hey.
We're noticing now that it's a real issue.
Yeah.
But where do we go from here? I'm glad to see you there. Mr. Mayor, I'm glad to see you. And I'm sorry. And all members of City Council, glad to see you here. We need education. But more important than education, African American males need opportunities.
Hand up.
When it comes to jobs and economic opportunities, we've been cast out. We've been cast out. Y'all know we got a black business. You know it's harder. You know it's harder if you don't have it's harder if you're somebody else. If you're not if you don't have an African business, it's tough. But where we go from now is we need more education. We need more sensitivity training. But more importantly than all of that, we need people of this community patrolling this community. Thank you, Senator Jackson. Thank you very much.
It is
so true. And we appreciate his remarks. We appreciate everyone's remarks. Thank you, Mayor, also for your remarks. And I do acknowledge Senator Diane Harvey Johnson as well. She is a wonderful person. If you need to know anything about our community and insight on how to better our community, she definitely has solutions. She definitely can lead you in the right direction. I appreciate you being here and everyone else.
Sorry. I was angry this morning when I woke up and I heard that 50 some of my brothers and sisters that I don't know them by name, I couldn't tell them by faith, but they're gone and their families are now grieving. I don't know about you, but I'm angry about it, and I will continue to be angry about it until something is done. But here is the key. She said we must not allow bitterness to take root, but anger then must be useful and become useful. She said write it. She said sing it. Dance it, draw it, paint it, whatever your talent, we must become useful in this community with the anger that we have. I don't know about you, some of you may not feel the same indignation that I do, but I feel that we have done something even by coming here today. But let it not stop here.
That's right.
Let this not be the end of it, and we all go home and we forget. I don't know about you, and I know that I'm clergy and I'm supposed to be talking about praying for Orlando, but you know what? Sometimes prayer must stop and their action must take place. I'm not saying
don't
pray, but I'm saying after you pray, get up.
Get to work. Get to work.
Do something about it. It's time for us as a community to join hands, and we're doing a wonderful job. I'm so proud of us to join hands and begin to really take action. We can do this not just for ourselves, but for our nation. We can be a beacon of hope. We can show the world, even from little old Savannah, that there was a group of people one day that heard about a great injustice that happened a few hundred miles down the road, but gathered together as a result of their anger, as a result of their indignation, and they did something positive with it. And we have people out here that are writers. I encourage you to write when you get home. Poets, I encourage you to write when you get home. Painters, I encourage you to paint when you get home. Dancers, dance about this. Singers, sing about this. Preachers, preach about this. It's too important for us to let this just die. Loving the person that's standing next to you.
That's easy.
That's easy.
Oh, yeah. She certainly is.
It could have been.